then you hope. He came back and he said, I am perfect. Be you perfect. And people don't even teach that. They don't preach that. And people are not even trying for that. They're not trying to ascribe to that level. They're satisfied, playing in sin, and coming back to God, I'm sorry. I did it before myself. But I was instructed by the best instructor in the world. And now that he's instructed me, I have no need for sin in my life. I got the same propensity to sin like anybody else in this room. I can do it better than some of y'all because y'all have never been in indulging as deeply as I was in sin. But something happened.
Hallelujah.
When he touched you, there is something happening in your life to make you hate the very appearance of evil.
Hallelujah. Right when you do it,
he's working on us right now. Now watch what he says here. Go to 1 Peter chapter 2. 1 Kefa chapter 2, verse number 24. For who himself bore our sins, listen at this now, in his body, on the stake. So that we having what? I hear somebody, one person say, what you say? Died. Somebody say, died to sin. Because I'm just showing you what the book's saying. Don't get mad at me. You don't want to talk about it to me? Come on. What did it say right there? Who himself bore our sins in his body on the stake or on the timber, so that we having died. To sin. Y'all see that?
Yeah.
And it didn't just say die to sin, it said what?
Sin.
Die to sins.
Sin.
We who have died to sins might live unto righteousness.
Hallelujah.
Because by his stripes,
hallelujah,
wherever the devil cut us, wherever the devil beat us, wherever the devil hurt us in our heart, wherever the devil walked on us and put us down, his stripes healed us from that. We came to him. And when we came to him, we had already established some diseases in our bodies because of our loose living. So when these diseases come upon us, all we can do is call on him who died. All we can do is call upon him who hears our humble cry, and he will come and minister to us by way of his medicine. He is here right now. But listen, I want you to pick up on this poor little verse. It's just a little small verse. In verse 24, he says, we should have died to sin. So if we have died to sin, why are we going back to look for it?
All right.
Somebody haven't died yet.
Help us, yeah.
Because if we died to it, we don't have no desire for it.
All right.
Huh? Have we really died to sin? Or do people still want to play with it?
Nope.
Look at 1 Kefa. Go to chapter 1. 1 Peter chapter 1. Look what it says in verse number 17. And if you call, I'm going to say it one more time. If you call on the Father, who without partiality judges according to everyone's work, pass the time of your sojourning in fear. Be mindful, your salvation is at stake. Knowing that you were redeemed from your future lifestyle, inherited from your fathers, not with what is corruptible, silver or gold, but you were redeemed with the precious blood of the Messiah as of a lamb unblemished and spotless. No sin was on him. But he gave his life. Somebody do this for me. He gave his life for me. That alone. I could really stop my sermon right there. But I can't stop because he's telling me to go on. But I'm going to tell you, I could stop right there, and that should be enough to make everybody, if you're not right, you're going to get right. Because if you know your soul got a chance to go to hell, you're going to tighten up. Unless you don't believe there is a hell. And some people don't. 1 John chapter 3, verse number 4. I'm going to show you this now because everybody needs to know why he died. I've shown you some stuff in here why he died. I went back and reread my notes and I did some highlighting in my own notes. Because I don't need notes if Father speaks to me. He lets me know where I'm good at and lets me know where I'm bad at. He lets me know what's working and he lets me know what needs repair. He's a good father. Hallelujah. So far, he ain't never told me that I've attained perfection yet. Every now and then, he look under his hand and see how I'm doing. Anybody else under his hand? Because he said, put yourself under the mighty hand of Almighty Yah, and he will exalt you in due season. So every now and then, he looks under there. You all right, boy? Yes, sir. Father.
Hallelujah.
But watch this. John, 1 John chapter 3, verse number 4. Everyone doing sin also does lawlessness. That means you're breaking the commandments. And sin is lawlessness. So if anybody telling you you can practice sin, they're telling you it's okay to break the commandments. Did y'all read that along with me? Well, let's go to the next verse. Look what it said. And you know. Uh-oh. Sound like Brother Johnson there. All of us should know this. And you know. Because he's got another one in Romans 8:28 says, and we know that all things work together for the good. But right here, look what he's saying. And you know that he was manifested for what reason? To take away our sins. And what else? And in him. I'm going to say it again. And in him. In him there is no sin. And Brother Blackwell clarified it? None. So when people who are in sin say, oh, you can't condemn me for my sin because I'm in the law. Over there what book that is? Romans, what book that is? Oh, wait a minute, I'm talking to somebody I don't know what I'm doing.
Romans 8:1.
There we go, somebody know what I'm talking about. Now, therefore, we cannot be condemned because we are aware. But we just found out in him there is no sin. So you can't run there. Because if you were in him in the first place, you wouldn't be over there doing sin. Oh, we didn't shout on that one, Brother Blackwell. Nobody didn't want to shout on that one. See, but I'm telling you right now, if you are in him, you are in the place of light because he is the light. We are in the place of no sin because he does not have sin in him. We're in the place of perfection. We're in the place of holiness. We're in the place of righteousness if we are in him. So don't come to me telling me you cannot be condemned because you are in him, because if you are in him, nobody can condemn you because you're perfect walking in him. What they gonna condemn you with if you're already in him? But stop using it as a cloak for your sinfulness. I'm not going to let you do it. Because the word is telling me not to let you do it. I got to make you understand what you're doing. You know what he said? Cry aloud and spare aloud and make my people what? To know their transgression and make Israel to know her sins. I want you to know where you're going wrong so you can get it right. You keep going wrong thinking it's right, you're going to go to hell. Your word depends upon you. Because see, people are going to perish for lack of knowledge. And because you reject his Torah and your children. And you think he's to be played with and preachers. Preachers don't have no remorse whatsoever telling people they can commit sin and go back out there and just have, just keep living your life. He didn't die for that already. Yes, he did die for our sins, but not for us to continue in this. Huh?
But it tells me past, present, and future.
That's what they're being told. So no matter what you do in the present, in the future, you covered. You're going to be covered, all right. You're going to be covered. You're going to be covered with some dirt. Because you're promulgating a lie and don't even realize it. Okay, watch this then. Where did that leave off at? 1 John 5? Let's go to 6. Everyone staying in him. How many of us staying in him? Right? How many of us residing in the master right now? So look what he's saying now. Everyone that's staying in him does not sin.
Hallelujah.
Everyone that is sinning, continuing in sin, continuing to sin, has neither seen him nor do they know him. Little children, don't let anyone lead you astray. The one doing righteousness is righteous, even as he is righteous.
Hallelujah.
Y'all still with me?
Amen.
I'm not finished yet. Verse 8. The one doing sin is of the devil. Because the devil has sinned from the beginning. For this purpose, the Son of the Most High was manifested. For what? To destroy the works of the devil. Now, if he is in you to destroy the works of the devil, why are you running after sin? You running after something to play rather than destroy? Then you done got fooled some kind of way. Help us, Father. Everyone having been born of the Most High does not sin. And everybody going around here right now, that's a common lingo now. A chantra. They're going around, I've been born again. Really? Look what it says right here. Everyone having been born of the Most High does not sin. That's not my words. Why? Because his seed stays in him. Huh? And he is powerless to sin because he has been born of the Most High. In other words, when sin comes at him, no, I can't do that. No, stay away from me. That's when you start calling on the Father. Hallelujah. Father, help! Sin knocking at my door. Satan want to sift me like wheat. Yeah. Call your brother. Call your sister. Say, pray with me. Sin is knocking on my door real loud. And I almost answered him. Please help me. But instead of that, we let sin come on in the house. Then we go back to the Father. Please forgive me. Next couple weeks, y'all been doing the same thing again. And you're blaming the devil. No, it's not the devil. Let's go to Yeshayahu chapter 53. That's Isaiah chapter 53, looking at verse number 5. Hallelujah. But he was